is October 22nd, and we're on pages 42 and 43. It's close to Halloween, but we don't have a very spooky article today. But that's okay, because it's day two of Green Living, and we're talking more about gems of the future, lab-grown diamonds.
没错，我们昨天呢简单的介绍一下实验室的这种钻石，对不对？哈，培育出来的钻石呢，事实上它比较便宜。然后呢，事实上呢，它跟一般的这种开采出来的钻石没有差别的。我们昨天简单讲了一下，它的那个色差呢，是跟这个一般天然开采出来的钻石是就很小、很微小的这种差异。老师也提到说，其他不同颜色的这种钻石呢，有很多像蓝色的啦、粉红色的啦。好，通常如果说今天有比较特殊颜色的钻石，往往就非常非常的贵。那我们今天要介绍一下，就是使用这些或者是购买这些实验室培育钻石有很多的好处。
Okay, so with that, let's take a quick break. And when we come back, we got paragraph one.
Gems of the future. Lab-grown diamonds. There are several benefits to using lab-grown diamonds. They are a better choice compared to mined diamonds because workers do not need to work in terrible conditions. In the past,Some diamonds came from mines that operated in war zones, particularly in West Africa during the 20th and 21st century. When customers buy a diamond produced in a laboratory, they don't have to worry about the ethical problems of how the stone made its way to the market. Lab-grown diamonds are also eco-friendly.Mining processes require digging deep below the Earth's surface, which creates damage to the environment. Mining even a 1-carat diamond results in a huge loss of land and a large amount of waste. For anyone who cares about the Earth, lab-grown diamonds seem to be a better choice. Furthermore,Lab-grown diamonds allow people to get bigger diamonds at affordable prices. Natural diamonds are known for being expensive because they are rare. Lab-grown diamonds can be produced in large quantities, which can reduce their prices. With these benefits in mind, lab-grown diamonds are definitely great choices that are worth considering.
Okay, friends, so again, we're on pages 42 and 43. As always, have your pen ready. And so yesterday we asked you the question, do you want a lab-grown diamond or do you want a real mined diamond or do you not want diamonds or jewelry at all? I told you guys, I just have like a cheap ring from like a night market. That's my wedding ring, but my wife and I don't even wear it. I just carry it with me because I want to.My wife doesn't carry her ring. 太过分。
哎呀，所以说我们昨天
Just kidding, I love you, baby.
Yeah, 没错没错，一定要讲这句话，不然就惨了啊、哦！我跟你说，老师刚刚昨天呢就提到说呢，事实上我们你可以买那种一般的那种开采钻石，或者是这种实验室钻石，或者呢可以像我们 Chris 老师一样，事实上你可以买一个这种没有钻石的这种婚戒，对不对？好像他跟他老婆两个都是比较简朴的人，你也可以选择用这样的方式，不需要这种其他人说一定要有钻石才有爱意啊，没有，你可以用自己的方式去对彼此表达爱意。像老师的话，他就是用这种方式在荧幕上，荧幕前面呢跟老婆说啊，超爱他这样。
Yeah, actually, the first rings, the first wedding rings.were usually made of grass, and they would kind of make grass rings for each other. And then later, rings were very simple, and they would have a key on them. Because there's no good banks, everything expensive and important is in your house. So when you marry someone, you give them the key to all of your stuff. So we still have this ring idea from a very long time ago.
对，所以说延续到以前的这种概念，最早的时候，这个戒指是用草啊，经常那种草编织而成，然后到后来慢慢的上面会有这个钥匙，因为这个家里头都是有重要的东西嘛，对不对？你把这个钥匙给人家了，基本上就是把你的心给他了，是一样的意思。
Right, yeah. So you always have that key with you. You can't put everything expensive in the bank. It's in your house, or someone might steal it. There are several benefits to using lab-grown diamonds. Okay, so we're going to learn more about the good things that come from lab-grown diamonds.
来，我们来先看一下第一段里头他怎么说的。这第一个呢，在这一段里面就会告诉你他为什么我们要选择实验室培育钻石。第一个好处是什么？他告诉你说 ，There are several benefits to using lab-grown diamonds。当你今天看到这个 several benefits to 这个 to 帮我把它圈起来，它是一个介系词 preposition， 所以后面如果碰到动词的话，要用 ving。好，在这里的话是 using lab-grown diamonds， 使用这种实验室培育钻石呢，有下列几个好处哦。
They are a better choice compared to mined diamonds because workers do not need to work in terrible conditions. What's the word we used yesterday?We use the word unpleasant for workers. They're really dangerous, and it's very hot, and it's very scary down there. If something happens, the mine falls on you, and you're not getting out. Maybe if you're lucky, it falls on you, and you die. If you're not lucky, the mine falls and closes, and you can't get out.
没错，因为事实上我后来想起来，我爷爷曾经在矿里头工作。
哇、wow. ！
所以说今天他有时候像隔壁的矿坑已经挖完了，然后下雨天的时候会积水。那如果今天你挖挖挖隔壁的这个矿坑，不小心挖穿了之后，那些积水就整个这样晃，然后变到这个矿坑里头来，然后之后你逃都没有机会。所以说今天除了这个环境很糟之外，死亡几率是相当相当的高的哦。
Yeah.
所以在这边这句话告诉你说 ，They are a better choice， 好 ，compared。To mine diamonds, 相较于这些天然开采的钻石来讲呢，我们这些实验室培育钻石是一个比较好的选择。特别注意一下 compared to, 这 compared 一定要是被动的方式，相较于是它被我们拿来比较嘛，相较于这些天然开采的钻石。Why? Because workers do not need to work in terrible conditions. 这个地方 terrible, 我们上一次昨天的时候是用到 unpleasant condition。 那我刚刚就跟你说了，我的祖父告诉我说，事实上在这个里面除了很热很闷之外，还有机会把命给丢了。
Oh, in the past, some diamonds came from mines that operated in war zones, particularly in West Africa during the 20th and 21st century. So when something operates in a placeThat means it works, it runs, or functions in a place. And a zone is just an area. So we have a war zone. This means a place a war is happening.
没错，在这边的话，我们看到说 ，in the past， 在过去呢 ，some diamonds came from mines. 好，很多这些钻石，有些钻石是来自于这些这种矿井或者是矿坑。That operated in war zones. 居然这些矿坑呢是在这种战区、哦、很多时候其实你在看到一些电影啊，像2006年的时候，你有机会去看到这个里奥纳多 DiCaprio 他有演了一部叫《血钻石》（Blood Diamond）， 他们提到这种 conflict diamonds or blood diamonds， 就是这些钻石本身呢是在这种战区去开采出来的，然后卖了的钱呢是用来资助他们这些内战恐怖分子之间互相打斗的这种资金，那变成是你买了这钻石，就等于变相的资助了这些内战的这种发生。所以在这边他讲的是这样的东西 ，particularly in West Africa， 好，尤其是在西非 ，during the 20th and 21st century， 在二十世纪还有二十一世纪的时候，尤其你有机会不小心买到这种冲突的钻石。
That's right. So a blood diamond is a diamond that is mined.In a war zone, and it's sold to pay for the army or soldiers to do something. Did you watch Blood Diamond?
Yeah.
Did you like it?
Yeah.
Do you remember a lot of the movie?
Yes, I still remember that. I use that in my class.
Really?
Yeah. 所以我话是跟学生们有的看部分的片段，然后看这个介绍一下当时的背景。
I remember one thing from this movie. Is this Hotel Rwanda? I'm getting confused. They're like, buy some beers.
Oh, some beers.
And they kept some beers. They talked about beers. Beer. But their accent, they said, buy some beers. And they would say it a lot in the movie. And so my friends and I are like, buy some beers.
老师会记得一些这种电影有很奇妙的片段。像魔戒他会记得说 potato.
You're right. Potatoes.
我也记得一些很怪的片段。
Why is my brain like this? Okay.
正常正常。
When customers buy a diamond produced in a laboratory, they don't have to worry about the ethical problems of how the stone is made, how the stone made its way to the market. So when we have a lab diamond, we don't have to worry, did someone die to get you this diamond? Or was someone, we have a gun, go get us the diamonds. That's really important.
没有错，所以说你要想到你在买钻石的时候，你不用担心说，哇，为了买这个钻石，这个钻石的背后到底是多少条人命就累积出来的，有没有人是被迫的，然后或者说这个钱到后来会不会变成军火，然后用来杀人，你就不用想这些事情。所以这边他又提到说了 ，When customers buy a diamond produced in a laboratory， 这个 lab grown 的这个 lab 其实就是这个字 laboratory， 就是实验室。当这个顾客买了一个实验室所培育出来的这样的钻石的时候呢 ，they don't have to worry about the ethical problems。The ethical problems 就是指这种伦理道德上的问题，说你不用担心说啊，这个背后有没有什么人要付出生命啊，付出一些代价。Of how the stone made its way to the market， 他们是这些钻石是如何进入到市场的这种道德问题，不用担心这个事。
This is also something I think about too when I do things. It does. Am I living in a good ethical way, or is this creating more problems? And I try not to live in a way that creates ethical problems. I imagine you feel very strongly the same way.
Yeah, 没有错。事实上，就是你会想说自己的行为有没有造成其他人的困扰。或是让人很多人付出代价只为了满足你自己这个欲望。
Yeah, I think if I wanted to marry a person and the person was like, I don't care about a blood diamond's ethical problems, I know that probably we shouldn't get married because our morals, 我们的那个 M-O-R-A-L, morals, they just don't match.
道德观啊，价值观啊，如果不太相符的话，其实很难在一起长久一辈子。
All right, let's take a quick break. And when we come back, we got paragraph two.All right, friends, welcome back to Enjoy English School. We're on pages 42 and 43. We're talking about gems of the future, lab-grown diamonds. We just learned about conflict diamonds or blood diamonds and the ethical or moral problems of buying diamonds from war zones. That's a tough one. Would you translate, Anthony?
Okay, 所以呢，我们在第一段刚刚前面提到的东西呢，就是说今天我们有机会，如果说是买这种实验室里头培育出来钻石的话，我们就不用担心，好，去买到天然开采的钻石过程当中碰到那种冲突钻石、血钻石，我们不用担心这些伦理道德的问题，好，这些东西的话都可以刚好避开。
Now, yesterday we talked a little bit about colors of diamonds and like the first artificial diamond. And we also said that lab-grown diamonds are 60% to 95% cheaper. And that includes colored diamonds, red diamonds, blue diamonds, yellow diamonds. But the most expensive and natural rare diamond is a red diamond.
所以说今天我们有提到说至少昨天有提到说这些这种钻石的这种色差啊，有不同颜色的钻石啊等等，我们有提到各式各样颜色的钻石嘛。其中呢，最贵最贵的啊，也最稀有的呢，是那种红色的 red diamonds。
Red diamonds are so rare that the GIA, the Gemological Institute of America, rated no red diamonds between 1957 and 1987. They didn't find a single red diamond.
OK, 所以说今天你老师刚刚提到一个这个组织叫做 GIA, 就是美国宝石协会。好，它因为这个红色的这种宝石太稀有了，所以在1957年、
right.
一路到1970几年的时候
,1987年
的时候 ,30 年的时间里面都没有认证过任何一个红宝石，因为这个红宝石太过稀有。
But with lab-grown diamonds, you're like, bro, I need a red diamond. And they're like, pow, here you go.
Yeah.
Win-win, man. Win-win.
Yes.
Let's continue. Lab-grown diamonds are also eco-friendly. They're good for, they're better for the environment. They're not good for the environment.
没错。所以在这里的话，我们看到第二个好处咯。好，这一段里面讲的第二个好处就是 lab-grown diamonds are also eco-friendly. 对环境来说呢，是比较友善的哦。
Mining processes require digging deep below the earth's surface, which creates damage to the environment. Please pick up your highlighter. Please highlight D-I-G-G-I-N-G. This has two G's. Highlight that.
没错，在这里的话 digging， 然后特别小心，要重复字尾之后再加 ing， 所以整句话说 mining processes， 好，这些采矿的过程呢 require digging deep below the earth's surface， 它必须要对这个地球表面进行深度的这种挖掘，然后呢，好，逗号后面是 which 这件事情呢 ，which creates damage to the environment。这个地方 creates 你也可以用 cause、causes damage to the environment， 就是这个过程会对环境造成很大的破坏。
Alright, don't forget that the surface, 短 I, the surface,、this means the outside part. Let's continue. Mining even a 1-carat diamond results in a huge loss of land and a large amount of waste.Okay, so carrot, C-R-A-T, 听起来像红萝卜一模一样。It has the same pronunciation. But of course, we spell the word differently. Carrot is from an Arabic word for bean pod, because it's about the size of a bean pod. 1 carrot is 200 milligrams.
啊，所以在这里的话，你要去记得这个 carrot 这个词，克拉是 200 milligrams
0.2 grams
哦，就是那种非常非常少。它的 milligrams 的话，应该是0.2克吧
？Yeah， 一克是零点二克
左右，非常非常小，非常非常，反正很贵就对了。总之 ，carrot 这个字呢，是来自于这个阿拉伯文的一个豆荚，就是非常非常小的豆荚里面的一个小豆子那样的感觉。所以他就说了 ，mining even a 1-carat diamond。就算你开采出一克拉这么小的这种钻石吧，好，它背后付出代价是什么呢 ？Results in a huge loss of land， 好，你会失去非常非常多的土地 ，and a large amount of waste， 还造成非常非常多这种废物，好，囤积的这种废弃物。
So waste in English is the unwanted or unusable stuff that we use after making something else. For example, when you peel a banana.The peel, like a pea, that's waste. You don't want to do anything with it, so you throw it out. You eat the banana, but the peel is waste.
不会啊，你可以拿来那个马里奥赛车的时候，可以拿来害别人，丢在滑倒。
Did we talk about the guy that eats the banana peel? There's an American football player, and he just eats the whole banana. It's the weirdest thing.
Wow.
He just eats it. People thought he was lying. He's like, bro, I eat it all the time.
You gotta be kidding.
I'm dead serious. He was like, I didn't know people peeled bananas. Like, what's the reason? 你不知道？
这太夸张了，这太神奇了，杰克。
He is very eco-friendly. He doesn't like to make waste.
啊，所以是那种没有任何废弃物的哈那样的状态。
Yeah. Okay. All right, let's take a quick break, and when we come back, paragraph 3. Hey, friends, welcome back to Enjoy English School. Anthony, I got a question. How do you cut a diamond? What do you use?
这个如果是要切这个，应该是用水哦，水刀吧。
You gotta use a diamond to cut a diamond.
哦，原来用钻石来去切割钻石。
But remember I told you, the ancient world also used diamonds. So how did they cut the diamonds out? How did you get the first diamond?
对啊，如果说今天如果你没有第一颗钻石去切的话，你怎么样？你怎么样在古代的时候，他们怎么样去做这件事情呢
？Well, they didn't. What they did is they would cut the diamond, they would cut the rock out, and then just clean the rock off, and then wear that diamond. They would wear the natural diamond. They wouldn't cut it at all.
哦，所以说他们之前以前在古文明的时候。开采出第一颗钻石，它本身是不会去切割的哦，它要想尽办法让这个用这种圆钻的方式去让它存在。
That's right. And so when we think of a diamond, we think of like 那个结婚的戒指的 diamond， 对不对？那个形状。But a real diamond looks like 2 pyramids stuck together at the base, and people would wear that on a necklace.
啊，所以说以前的时候它是那种八面体，就像两个那种金字塔一样，好，底座连在一起，他们会放在这边，像是那个钻。钻戒把它挂在这个像项链一样的那种方式去戴在身上。
Cutting diamonds is a very modern thing.
啊，所以说切割钻石是现代才有的事情。
Let's continue paragraph 3. Furthermore, lab-grown diamonds allow people to get bigger diamonds at affordable prices. So you get more for less. Good idea.
Yeah, 所以第三个好处呢，就是第三段所讲的，好，在价格方面比较实惠。 Furthermore, 此外呢 lab-grown diamonds, 好，这种实验室培育钻石 allow people to get bigger diamonds at affordable prices. 它可以用比较实惠的价格买到比较大颗的钻石。
Natural diamonds are known for being expensive because they are rare and getting mining them out of the earth is also very expensive.
嗯，没错。所以接下来下面这句话就告诉你说 natural diamonds, 那种天然的钻石呢are known for being expensive. 好，大家都知道很贵。Why? Because they are rare. 它们很稀有。Rare 这个字就是很少、很稀有的意思。
Lab-grown diamonds can be produced in large quantities. We can make a lot of them, which can reduce their prices. Because there are so many, we can sell them for cheaper.
Yeah, 所以接下来要告诉你说 lab-grown diamonds can be produced in large quantities.指的就是可以大量生产，因为可以大量生产呢 which can reduce their prices, 那这个价格也可以把它拉下来。
All right, with these benefits in mind, lab-grown diamonds are definitely great choices that are worth considering. So these benefits, they're good for the environment, there are no ethical problems, West Africa blood diamonds, they are eco-friendly and they're friendly to workers. These seem like, and they're cheaper,These sound like really good reasons to get a lab-grown diamond instead of getting one from a diamond mine.
嗯，没错。所以在这里的话，基于前面所讲的这些事情 ，with these benefits in mind， 这些好处在这个好处都列下来之后，你发现到哇，居然可以避免掉道德问题、冲突钻石，然后呢又可以对地球友善，然后又比较便宜，这样种种这样加起来 ，lab-grown diamonds 结论来喽 ，lab-grown diamonds are definitely 绝对是。Great choices that are worth considering. 值得你好好考虑的一个非常棒的选择。
Don't forget to tell us, do you want a lab-grown diamond? Do you want a real mined diamond or no diamonds at all? Maybe you want something else. Tell us, I love to read these comments and always thank you for saying such nice things. And sometimes people saying not nice things, that's okay too. Thank you for telling me. All right, for Enjoying the School, I'm Chris Gorski.
I'm Anthony.
We'll see you guys next time. Bye-bye! Bye-bye.